product development to me is like art. And I tell people, drawing a schematic is artwork. Laying out a circuit board is artwork. Creating the product, manufacturing the product is artwork. Like all these things, it really is art.
Another thing I love doing with Altium Designer is importing custom graphics because there's this artistic element to it. So here I have the DEF CON logo, my logo here in the middle. And then on the front side of the board, we actually had a full silk screen of this special DEF CON artwork here. But some of the tricky stuff with this board was dealing with the breakout for the micro BGA parts. So here's the NFMI part over here, the NHX2261. And these ball sizes are pretty small, at least for me. Again, I'd never worked with this technology before, so it made me feel good being able to use Altium and use the features that were set in. The crazy thing about this project too is, you know, doing my DFM and making sure everything was set with my design rules and verifying all of that is we made 6 prototypes and then had 7 days to go from prototype to full production with no time at all to make any significant changes. And luckily the boards worked and then went from 6 to 28,600 boards in 7 days. And I don't think that would have been possible without Altium.
This is my first professionally produced circuit board. This is what's called a POCSAG decoder. POCSAG is a wireless pager transmission protocol. And this is something you'd plug into a radio and you'd plug this side into your PC and you'd have some special software running on it that would decode all of the pager transmissions that were being sent over the air, received by the radio. This is something that I turned into a kit and sold at the loft to fund, you know, all of the bills that we had to pay at the loft. So this is really fun. But I quickly learned about circuit board design and what to do and what not to do, and realized that I can place components wherever I want and change the routing around. So I would have done this a lot differently nowadays, but it was a good first project.
Now, I don't design products to make money. I do it to put things in the world that need to be there that somebody could use or that I could use or enjoy in some way. Technology for technology's sake is not what I like. I like technology for certain purposes to let me do something and hopefully change the world with it.
Right on top, this is the FluidSense FS01. This is the portable infusion pump to infuse medicine into humans. So sort of, you know, like IV bags, but this will let the medicine flow at different flow rates and kind of, you know, infuse medicine as they need it. We went through full FDA testing, full manufacturing for it, and that's where I learned a lot about how to do production manufacturing, going from prototype to production.
I'm an engineer by lifestyle because I've grown up around it and I love it. And I've learned that it's okay to be different. You know, it's like I don't have to necessarily conform to standards of what people expect as an engineer or as a hacker. But for me, and when I got into hacking was all about curiosity, exploring, you know, questioning everything, sort of making products do things that they weren't intended to do by the original designers. Like all these things, not taking things at face value. And that's really what hacking means to me, and that's what it will always mean to me.
Please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.